Hey, welcome to the 6-Inch Show, episode number 30. I am Fly Guy from FlyGuy.net, joined as always by my co-host, Matt, from Instagram.com/ Star Wars The Black Series. How are you?
Tired.
It's been a long weekend. You're at Comic-Con this weekend, and we got a lot to cover. You got a lot of posts as well. We've got a lot of stuff to cover. Very quickly, let's see Matt's shelf and see what's on the shelf this week.
What have we got? So we've got Admiral Piet finally turned up.
Nice.
He's there. We've got two SH Figure Arts figures, which I'm about to put up for auction because I can't stand them.
Shoulder gappage is the issue, yes.
Yes. I'm going to get in trouble, I know, in comments and stuff, but I just, for everything they do good, their R2-D2 is spectacular. Their Han Solo is pretty good. Their Luke Farmboy is the best of the Farm Boy Lukes, but their troopers are terrible. I know that people like articulation, but I live on the side of look over articulation.
You don't want to see it, do you? It's
kind of, no. And these guys look in part their shoulders and stuff. They look like those Lego figures.
Okay.
Awkward looking, and I don't know. I just don't like them. I thought I'd buy them and splash out, but I got them and just went, nah.
So your Luke is in honor of?
Oh, yeah. Then there's Luke. Luke's in honor of the reveal.
Dun, dun, dun. We get a Luke. Good story. Yes. We'll talk about that.
The Black Spidey is also in honor of the two-pack out of NYCC.
Which is a good point, because that Kraven and Spidey pack, which we'll cover and show photographs to everyone who's watching, they're both kind of recent kind of figures. It seems a bit weird to bring them out again. But anyway, we'll dive in. We'll get Star Wars first.
Could then be an anniversary. I'm not sure.
Oh, that's a good point. Is it an anniversary? Oh, maybe of the Kraven's Last Hunt.
Years of Kraven Last Hunt or something. I'll look it up whilst we start this show. I'll look it up.
Sounds good. Okay, so Matt and I are going to cover everything Hasbro, pretty much a little bit of SH Figure Arts in there from 2018's New York Comic Con, which just happened literally just a few hours ago, just wrapped up. Everything we talk about and everything we show in the show notes in terms of images is below in the description. So if you want to click and go and have a look at it, Matt's toy photography that he gathers up, or any of the links that I've gathered up, all that kind of information from Hasbro is all under the page. Let's dive in. The very first thing we got is, or we got to see, first of all, from there was a few starts and stops, because some stuff kind of got leaked a little early, so a lot of posts were deleted, trying to keep Hasbro happy, but we finally managed to get to see what we knew was coming, but it's incredible to see it, is General Grievous, which was pretty damn amazing, it has to be said. This is a very, very nice looking figure. Got some, although you can barely see it there, there is a little bit of room in the cape for lightsabers. Comes with four sabers and detachable arms. Did you pick up on the thing about this, and beautiful cape, did you pick up on the comment Steve made about the scale of this figure?
No, I didn't.
Okay, he said something. I'll have to dig out his Instagram. On his page or his post, if anybody's watching, maybe you can clarify. He said something about the scale of this figure being, he had to make it a little bit out of proportion to do it justice. So I think maybe Grievous is a little bit taller than normal, or he should be in scale. So we might get the reverse of what we got, if you remember way back with Slave Leia or Leia Bush, where people kind of literally crap the bed about it. They just went a bit nuts about the scale and the size. So I don't know. I'll try and dig out the comments as we talk as well. But pretty nice. I'm quite impressed with this. A big surprise, I think, to a lot of people was getting to see this.
Yeah, I liked it. I think these glam shots did the figure more justice than the shots that everyone shared from the round table on Thursday morning, Friday morning, Thursday.
Yep.
Whatever day it was, Thursday night. Thursday morning, however it worked. Yep. They had the cape on wrong on the table, and it made it look really weird, but the cape tucking under his neck plate thing or whatever it is looks really good. And, you know, the figures, I'm surprised the glam shots didn't do it as a two-arm instead of four-armed figure as well, but it is, there is the option of two arms and four arms.
Mm. We'll get more close-ups in time and we'll see a bit more, but they've definitely got the bone-coloured plating that he has on him, kind of down pat. I think they've definitely done that. And Grievous is, he bugger of a figure to make. They did an excellent job in the vintage collection, but he still wobbled everywhere. And it was hell to hold the lightsabers, but it looks as if they've done a very, very fair job. So impressive.
And, you know, it's not an exclusive as was being reported, which I think you and I both knew for other reasons.
Yep.
So it's not an exclusive. It is a $29 figure, and they're continuing this deluxe pricing for these figures, which by all means, as I've always said, I'm supportive of, even if it costs me more money.
Yeah, sure.
I want to see better figures done, and if they're going to cost $10 more, that $10 is going to cost you and I $20 or $30 more, but, you know, bigger figures that aren't necessarily exclusives.
Yes, I agree.
And so that's, I think that's the trade-off, and that's what people have to accept, and I know it's an unpopular position to take, but I think certain figures cost more than other figures, and you just have to be prepared for that.
Well, I mean, the Gamorrean Guard has been a huge success, if you can find it. It's scalper heaven for that one. Moloch, I don't think, has really been quite the hit anybody wanted.
It's the figure that nobody wanted.
Exactly. It's the figure that nobody wanted. Well, I think, as well, it's just he's less of an action figure underneath that jacket. I always find figures with big, long capes like senators, and they're just... They just don't have that kind of dynamicness about it that they can move around. So he's not a great example. But there's, I think, as we both know, some more deluxe are clearly in the works, and some are kind of already quite well strongly hinted at too. So it's, yeah, the line, as long as you get the right figures, that will make the difference.
Absolutely. But, and again, I guess to harp on about it or not harp on or whatever, Moloch is the perfect example of what should be an exclusive. And Gamorrean Guard's a perfect example of what should be an exclusive.
Totally, that is so true. Absolutely so true. Don't do original trilogy aliens. Yeah, so right. You're so right. The other figure, which was a genuine surprise, I think, to both of us, we did know the Motherlode, as we called it, a lot of figures. But correct me if I'm wrong, but I mean, I knew nothing about this. I'm completely blindsided by this. But I guess it makes sense with Grievous.
Yeah. I think it does, and I think it's pointed out it's a very easy figure to make, a bit of fabric at the clone trooper body, and a new incredible Obi-Wan Kenobi head sculpt.
Exactly.
I think the other thing I was seeing about this figure was people there going, oh, it's from the 2003 Clone Wars series, and therefore he should have had the Jesus hair, the Episode 2 hair. But the second season of Clone Wars, he had the short hair. When Anakin got the long hair and the blue stuff. So it's just, look, at the end of the day, they've remade a 6-inch version of that Sideshow Collectibles figure.
Mm. I kind of get the feeling that facial sculpt there with a little whisper of white and kind of salt and pepper here would be the perfect popping onto the figure for an archive release almost.
Yeah.
So kind of, there's a bit of a kind of reuse from that facial sculpting here. I think that could pretty much be a good.
They have said that they're not going to do that, but I think it's a different thing when you're putting two figures together for the archive. Like, they're saying that they're not going to retool, but I guess by putting piece one and piece two together, it's not really retooling. Because they can't fix that other Obi-Wan with just a better paint job when you've got this one sitting there.
No, true. That's very true. Or maybe the head pops off and you buy a couple more Walgreens. Well, this one sadly isn't exclusive, as we know. This is exclusively at Walgreens, which at least for people outside, well, you know, the entire rest of the world, there's a slim chance we can get it, at least from the fact that Walgreens is so ubiquitous across the States. Let's hope we get a little bit more distribution outside the States, because again, it's another really popular figure. But the interesting thing that came out from this, and I kind of literally crapped myself when I saw it, I thought, what is this? What is this thing here, this little Dorito shoe that he's got on here? And I've asked Hasbro, I'm sure you maybe did too, and Steve, to see, like, what's this? What's going on? And they kind of hinted on some... panels. I think it was a sci-fi panel, the live stream, that these stands would be coming 2019 onwards, but didn't really get into the specifics of where they would be. Somebody suggested that they would only be in exclusives, which, as I've said, let's maybe get that writing first, because no one's actually really confirmed it. But speculation and rumours abound. But what do you think of this? Are you happy to get something like that? Do you think that looks pretty good for you?
Look, if it works and they've made it, it works for me. You know, it's not going to be something where you have to worry about whether it's going to work for the figure or not. If they've made it, you know it's going to work for the figure. I just think the most hilarious thing out of this is the fact that everyone seems to have a running action, whoever's using them this week.
I know. The Hasbro toy photographers, they're on something, man. But look, you know, it's a dynamic pose. I get what they're trying to do. And a lot of the times we see these photographs and you and I bitch about them. It's like, what kind of weird pose have you got that damn thing in? Or they're holding the blaster the wrong way or something. And I think it's also, there's a whole bunch of mom and dads and younger kids out there that just don't care like we do. But Kate looks a bit nasty and a bit slim and cheap, but I guess it'll do the job. But great facial sculpt. Really, really good facial sculpt on that guy. So Obi-Wan coming to Walgreens, which is quite nice. Looking forward to that. And that's spring 2019 for those who are asking me today. Archive packaging. So we talked about this before. Just bring it up again on screen. We've got some nice shots here of this archive packaging. This is, again, was from the sci-fi panel, the live stream, I should say. So if you get a chance to track that down, you may get a better close-up here. But this is Gregory Titus's artwork in the back, and a nice little introduction to show the original packaging, which I thought was lovely. That was really nice. They've got a kind of hint of the red for the it really shows red there rather than orange, and blue for the original packs. And then in front of the pack, which is the first, well, again, we'd seen the mock-up of Boba, but they actually look better to me, and a few people said this, they look better than the black and red packaging. What do you think?
Look, I don't mind it. I like it. Whether it looks better than the red and black, I'm not sure. I think that comes back down to the fact that we've been looking at the red and black for 3 years now.
I suppose.
And this is new. It's got the benefit of not being almost a legacy package. So, you know, they've made it look interesting, and I like the artwork on the back. I like it. It is a bubble, so you have to open it to open it.
Yep. Yeah, that's true. That's a good point. It's back to the blister back tip to the, stuff.
Yeah, yeah, so it's back to the blister. One for me, one for the shelf, and one just in case.
Yeah, exactly. Damn, that's a good point. Forgot about that. Anyway, so blister packaging is coming. We thought we'd kind of seen it all, and I really wasn't expecting much more. And oh boy, what a set of images to open up this morning. The very first one I saw was this. Wow, I was just blown away. I don't know about you, but that is clone trooper porn. That is just gorgeous.
It is, but it's not a clone trooper.
Rocket trooper. Sorry, yes.
That's a stormtrooper from the Empire.
There you go. Was this in Clone Wars? The Michael series?
No, it was. It was in. From what I can tell, it was in Star Wars Rebels, and there was a version of the rocket trooper in Battlefront, the first Battlefront, or the second Battlefront, one of them.
I wonder how they're going to kind of add that to, you know, how they kind of sometimes add some details onto the boxes for some of the details, you know, like Battlefront, or is this what it was from? That's a jump. Oh, that's it. It's a jump trooper.
Yeah, it's from Battlefront, but that's they moved it from Battlefront into some of the episodes of Star Wars Rebels.
Ah, there you go. Okay, maybe a little Battlefront on the box, who knows. Or Rebels. Interesting. That's a very cool looking figure, nonetheless. We'll get back to some other pictures in a minute. The other one, which you and I, you were very excited about, was which really just looks like a completely everything is the same bar the head, is Luke Skywalker, Stormtrooper disguise, wet hair version.
Long time coming. And I honestly couldn't be happier. It was the thing. Everyone's like at San Diego Comic-Con last year. And I loved everything at Comic-Con last year as far as the dewback and the diorama and everything that was awesome. Are we going to get a Millennium Falcon cockpit, all this stuff? I just wanted to know one thing. Can we get a wet hair Luke? Exactly. That's all I wanted out of everything. And I love the Dewback and stuff, but wet hair Stormtrooper Luke was my Comic-Con thing from last year. And so
yeah, that's true.
It's such an easy repack. It's such an easy figure. And again, it's an exclusive this time to Target. And I know there's going to be people upset with it, but as much as I love this figure and I want it and I'm going to get it no matter what anyway, it's that thing that to me that still is a good exclusive. I don't think that Bespin Escape Leia is a good exclusive, but I think a variant of a figure that's already been released in a Stormtrooper Luke makes sense as an exclusive to me.
Yeah, it does. That's very true. And the figure wasn't the hardest to find overall. I think I just gave you one of mine recently, wasn't it? It was you, wasn't it? I think it was. Uh-huh. Spare one? Oh, I don't know, so it was. But, you're right. It's a figure that's came out before, and just a little bit of paint and deco. Yeah, if you give it as an exclusive. I wish, though, they wouldn't do Target, I think, for something like that.
I was about to say.
A fancy maybe, thing. That's,
yeah, a Piet. Like a Piet, like give everyone the opportunity to get it online.
Yeah.
But I think variants and exclusives should start making their way to online.
Yeah, it's driving a lot of people. It's very, very annoying. But maybe 2019 will sort some things out. I think what is noticeable is from Hasbro's PR information, they've definitely been much more, although they're kind of biased towards one distributor, the point is they have, through several of these press releases and the information you sent us both, been very careful to say available at fan, I can't remember the exact name, what they called it. It was down for the vintage fan retailers, basically, which is really online stores, BBTS, Drop Street Toys, Entertainment Earth, and a few others. So that is good, because that's online stores. That means global distribution. That means a chance to get the figure. So.
And it is a change in tact from...
Nice.
Yeah.
So, seems to be vintage collection more than 6-inch, though, which is a bit of a sucky problem. So I don't know what's going on with that one. The Rocket Trooper, we should say, which actually ties in more with the Battlefront comment you mentioned, is exclusively to GameStop.
Yeah.
Let's hope that's EB Games for Canada, EB Games for us here in Australia, etc. Back with the figures, and we had another, I tell you one thing about these stands that I really love, and I absolutely was so happy, and I mentioned to Steve Evans today, I was like, oh my God, you made clear stands, which is really important. They're a little bit smoky, which is fine, but they're clear, and that is great for kind of not detracting from the figure. If it was green or black, it kind of, if you got an all-white shelf, it looks like a bunch of Doritos scattered everywhere. It would be really weird. So at least the clear is a little bit kind of translucent. And the other thing as well is you can turn those two little triangles, I thought in my head, opposite ways. So you can kind of actually get quite a lot of figures in a cabinet or a shelf with them. So I think it's a good design, but the truth we'll find out when we get to see them. That's another nice shot, although I'm not sharing it on screen. That'd be really helpful if I shared it on screen with you. Well, I was talking about it, but there we go. So clear Doritos. One of the rest of the figures, there's another look at the Battlefront Trooper or Rebels Trooper. And Dr. Aphra in 6-inch scale, which fan favorite. Don't know about that helmet, whether it's removable. I didn't see any other shots over. I don't think she needs to have a removable, personally speaking.
Does she remove it in the comments?
I don't know. That's a very good point. I don't think she does. But nice figure. That's going to be very, very popular. And that does look like the 3PO mold reused, I guess.
Is it 3PO or is it Forlom? Does it have articulation to the arms?
He has the same piston. You're right. It's Forlom. They've got the same little pistons going on by the looks of it. Yeah, it does. It's got the little grooves. But he's got
3PO's stomach wiring. It's probably a combo of both with new hands.
And a little bit of a saw here. Bizarre. And a little blaster or something in the finger. They're crazy asteroids. BT-001 or 001, I can't remember.
Just BT-1?
BT-1. Is there no double zeros in there?
I don't think so. I don't know. I'm lost.
Oh, it's 000 in BT1, my apologies. I'm getting just thick. He looks actually really good. I think all the kind of attachments and the crazy war machine-like part there and bits and pieces, like a foghorn there. I don't know. Not too bad. Not too bad. Lots of accoutrements on him. And just another shot there. Swap out hands, which is kind of nice. I guess these are like surgical scissor hands. Edward Scissorhands stuff going on there. And they are not a three-pack. They are single release figures. There's a rumor going around. People spread some real shit around when the kind of stuff comes out. Yeah, it's a three-pack at GameStop. No, it's not. So
available. Mainline as well.
I know, mainline as well, not exclusive. So
I would go the other way. Whilst talking exclusives, I would have made, in a perfect world, Luke, Rocket Trooper, and Obi-Wan mainline.
Yep.
And I would have made these three exclusive. Again, when you're dealing with fan size, I guess.
Yeah. I think they're popular enough, these three characters, given that Aphra is at least coming out in the vintage collection, and she's been popular. And the three-pack San Diego pack was pretty popular too. So... people say, yes, 000 and BT. I thought we were only getting that. So that's a very good point there. They thought they were only getting Aphra from the fan polls. Very cool. I like them. I'm very impressed with those figures. I think you are too. Definitely the two Tripper-like figures are big, big fan pleasers. I think that's big, big crowd pleasers. What else did we have? There's a couple of other things. In amongst all the Hasbro New York Comic Con stuff was a Bandai Obi-Wan Kenobi, which came out just about a week ago, or just under a week. Very cool looking. I thought it was worthwhile looking at some of the photographs. And good timely kind of release or information release prior to New York Comic Con, with both of these figures getting, or both of these characters in some way getting a release and a mention. There we go. So... just sharing some shots here on screen with Obi. There's a couple of really nice shots of him. The face is, I don't know what's going on with the face, man.
Yeah, I get in trouble, but no, I'm but sorry. They
that's
went
not from, bad. That's not bad.
Yeah, they went from heroes to zeros on face sculpts. They really have. Like, that's
not terrible. That's pretty...
it's not you and McGregor. That's not. They, for a company that nailed it with... Episode 1, Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Yes, they did a decent job
with Episode 2. It's still not the best. See, that one's the best one.
That is the best one, I agree.
But it's just... their specialty was their heads, and it's like... come on, guys. $80.
I know. Well, I think definitely with facial scan tech, particularly, I just got this week the Bespin Leia... Bespin Escape Leia, and the facial paint is, I mean, again, for I wish it cost me $20, but the time I get it, it doesn't cost me that, but by the time, you know, I got it, it was a lot more, but still, for what is a predominantly a $20 figure, $22 figure, stunning, really stunning. So the facial scan tech, I think, is pretty superb. Anakin looks very strange.
Yep.
Anyway, yes, $160 worth of figures plus shipping, that's just too much, man. But then again, if you love those characters and that's your thing, that scene, which a lot of people I know just adore, you know, go do your thing. Go do your thing. Now, there was something else we covered, the archives, didn't we? What else?
Yeah, we haven't talked about the, we can either do it later when we get to my page or we can do it now, which is the new archive figures.
Yes, the Yoda, and the, yes, good point. We'll come back to it. So we'll stay tuned. We'll come back at Matt's page because he's got some of the live press photographs, and we'll cover that too. So yes, there's more Star Wars Hasbro Black Series to come. Very quickly, this was something that I just wanted to... I was talking to the guy, the owner this week, talking about stands. This was prior to Hasbro stands coming out, but still, these are pretty nice. And what is interesting is they have an operation in quite a few places in the globe. So they have a store in the US and have a store in Australia as well. And Ian's Displays and they sell these stands. So I got some. We're going to have a look at them. Somebody said to me the other day, you're a bit of a stand slut. And I was like, yes, I am. I love a good stand. So these are kind of interesting. Different angles, peg holes, you know, different poses. So I'm always up for trying stuff there. So I'll put a link in the show notes. Definitely check them out. And there's a lot of other stuff, not just Black Series, vintage. There's even diorama parts and pieces. So, yes, display accessories, Ian's display accessories. Check them out. Pretty nice store and a lot of good feedback. A couple of people have put me onto them. And I'm going to check them out because they're actually quite nice for some figures if you've got certain backgrounds. But yeah, I think I might be clear through and through. But we'll see. We'll have a look at them. That was them. Let's get a quick look at Marvel. So Marvel was also being released in New York Comic Con. Tons of stuff there. We'll quickly go through it. But one of the first ones, closest to Matt's heart, Kraven Black Spidey. That looks like the same Spidey that we kind of just had.
It is, I believe. And again, I've got a photo of it on my page for later. But there's a beaten up Peter Parker head that pops on.
So that is. That's right. I forgot that. And Kraven's got a new head sculpt. Actually, he doesn't have that teethy.
He's got the I don't know what you'd call it. The scrunched up angry face going.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because previously it wasn't. It was a kind of, you know, neutral face.
But Tom Selleck Magnum face.
Yes, it was. It was a great figure. Not one that I love, but a great looking figure in the sculpt and the design. And I think they've added a lot more tiger print stuff going on. And
they've gone to the more, someone was saying, the more classic comic.
Craven. Yep. Who dresses like that in New York? I always have to bring in the reality of the comics. And I'm just like, really? Who is a bit bare-chested with a big line on the chest? I'm off to see The Lion King in Broadway. So this is a two-pack coming from Hasbro. We'll get the dates and the prices for you. Hasbro have given us that below. We'll get a look at that in a minute. This looks pretty nice. Is this Corbin Glaze, this one? I can't remember the guy's name. Let's have a quick look at the names again before I forget. Corvus Cleave and Ebony Maw, that's the two characters here. But beautiful looking sculpts on these guys. Very impressed we're getting the rest of these characters. I guess Infinity War has been a hit for Hasbro.
So this is the completing the set figure. Mm.
After I've just sold my big Baff. But he's beautiful looking, very, very cool indeed. I think the MCU fans, just as the movies have become so big, I think that the movie fans have also increased, and we want more movie characters, and they can do them now amongst waves and do a lot more, which is really, really nice. Beta Bill. What's his name again? I am just all over the place today. Beta Ray Bill. I was right. I just can't pronounce this. Like a conundrum for the tongue. Movable jaw, I think, from what I saw in a picture earlier on. Not quite sure. Thor cape, pretty much a Thor kind of body. And there you go. Not really one for me or you, I don't think.
No. Nope.
This was the name I can't remember either. Thresher. No, that wasn't Night Thresher. That was Caliban, I think it was.
Yeah.
That's Caliban. Build a figure. Pretty good. Very scary looking facial sculpt on that. Do like that, though. I like the difference in skin tone for the suit and the body. Sometimes they just tend to use all one color and just not worry about it, but that's pretty nice. I do like that. And this is, again, this is a fan exclusive or fan online site. So again, that's BBTS, Drop Suit Toys, Entertainment Earth, and a few others. I've got this, I think, very nice looking Hydra Captain America, and what looks like the old Baff of Arnim Zola, tarted up with some new paint and a little weapon and a different sticker in the chest.
I think somebody said, and I don't know because I don't even know who the character is, that it might also be new arms that are
out of
size. Is it Colossus's arms now?
Could well be. That's a good point, actually. Could well be. I'm just assuming that they're using the old Baff of Arnim Zola, which was probably pretty much the same. Yeah, there's a couple of really interesting comics where he's in, where Captain America goes away into this kind of weird world and has a kid and has a life and then comes back. He spent another 100 or 80 years in a different place. It's very bizarre, but That's where I remember Arnim Zola from. But I do love this Hydra cap. This is very cool. Not a very popular comic series, but that's a very cool looking figure.
He looks like Captain Australia.
Trying to find toys on the internet. Yes, go save his cap. This is, oh my God, who is this guy again? I'm all over the place tonight. This is Caliban. This is Caliban. And he is, God, he looks so 70s with the tassels and the boots. A lot of these guys look as if they should have been kind of in the village people in some ways. They're kind of very, you know, big chested and, you know, oh my God, and this bandana here. But very much out the comics, that's for sure, color-wise, from what I know of him, and a very impressive-looking weapon, which looks very unique to him, and a bit of a Deathlok leg, I think, there. Not bad. This is Night Thrasher, which looks very much like it's using a lot of the Electro body and a few other parts and pieces, and Daredevil's batons, if I'm not correct, if I'm not wrong.
I think some of the figures were good, but I just don't care outside of that first two.
Well, for me, it's the MCU, so at least there's something for everybody. There's a lot of different comic characters in there and some really kind of older fan pleasing ones from comics, but that wasn't a bad bunch of releases. And another good chance to get Black Spidey and Kraven, which are both popular figures. So
it's going to make my Sinister Six get that much closer. I can't remember who I need after that now. I think it's just going to be Vulture.
Nice.
Yeah.
Cool figure. So yeah, there we go. The Supreme Leader and Arnim Zola are fan channel retailers. That is basically what they're calling it. Fan channel retailers, which is, as we know, Dorsey Toys, BBTS, etc.
So if X-Force dude was Caliban, who's the other dude again? Who's the purple and white dude? What's his name?
This guy?
Yeah.
Buff. He is the Build-A-Figure. He is Caliban.
So he's Caliban, and who's the X-Force guy?
Oh, no. Oh, my God. What am I like? Forge is this guy here. This is Forge.
Okay, cool.
This is Caliban. So who's the Buff? Oh my God. Anyway, we'll pick up the images. Be the Rebel, Forge. Caliban build a figure. Yes, so Caliban is this big dude here. All right, on with some other stuff from Hasbro. What else did they have? This could bunch of stuff. I don't know why, but the very last minute, and Hasbro still haven't sent through a proper press image for it, but one was leaked out to some store somewhere, and then it kind of got out somewhere else. Jubilee from the X-Men. So, yeah, she was a last minute kind of a kind of glam shot with her bubblegum on her face there, very much the 80s X-Men look. So that was another one there. Didn't give us any other press information on this figure, exactly what it would be. But there you go, we'll get more in time. What else did we have? We had a couple of box shots came out from Hasbro today as well. They had, we knew both of these figures, but we'd only seen loose images. This was the Deadpool Corpse Ride with Dogpool and Squirrelpool, and that is Hydra Bob. So if you bought the two-pack of Hydra figures, or you bought the previous two-pack of Hydra figures, you can take that head and pop that onto one of the Hydra soldiers and make Hydra Bob, which is from Deadpool Comics, basically Deadpool's buddy. So kind of interesting pack there. We've got a little comic-like horn. He's got his scooter and crazy figures, Dogpool and Squirrelpool.
And they've got stickers.
The stickers, that's right, there's a sheet of stickers, which is all I Love Logan and all sorts of stuff, and a very interesting sheet of stickers. Yeah, I meant to share a picture of that, actually. There's one doing the rounds. Let me stop that and show you the other box shot, which was Charles Xavier. Have you ever watched Legion?
Not yet.
Stunning show, so good. But one character in there is Farouk, a.k.a. the Shadow King. And he comes with a head on there, so you can basically be Farouk on Xavier's body if you want.
or Farouk or on Kingpin's body.
Farouk on Kingpin's body. There you go. Good point. We've got Charles Xavier's helmet and his wheelchair. I don't think we can really... They did take the word rides off this, which I felt was a little bit... Wheelchair's not exactly a ride. It was a little bit kind of... Anyway, we get the little blast effect for it and the cushioning in the back. So, yeah, pretty good. Pretty good.
They're the first two that I would contemplate buying.
Mm.
Of the vehicle ride-alongs slash wheelchair.
Mm.
Maybe I should have thought about Ghost Rider, but no.
You can still get it. It's not hard to find. I can't remember whether we covered Captain Marvel high-res picks the last time.
I don't think we did.
No, I don't think we did. So very, very quickly, in between this, in a very bizarre move, Amazon gets the pre-release for Captain Marvel movies, which was to tie in with the trailer. But yet they only allow them to buy four movie figures. There's obviously another three figures in the wave, or two figures in the wave, really, or it depends on if they double pack. Very bizarre what they did, but we got this soldier, the Marvel soldier. We also got Captain Marvel as well. A lot of discussion about this facial sculpt. Includes additional head, two additional hands. Samuel L. Jackson, badass MF, in that reused suit. And we'd seen pictures of these, but these are just higher res pics. You mentioned the actor who played this.
It's Ben Mendelsohn.
Ben Mendelsohn, thank you very much. And all of them build this kind of Kree skull sentry. So, but yeah, there's obviously other figures in this wave. We kind of know some of them, but we'll leave that to Hasbro to confirm it. But yeah, that was a kind of bizarre one to release and to give Amazon a pre-release for these. Kind of bizarre. So I believe they go up. I think it's 1 December, I think, for other retailers to list, or 1 January, I think it is. So very odd. But there you go. That's what Hasbro wanted. So over to them. Another figure that came out this week and just blew me away, or came out a little bit last week, and then this week we get better pictures, was the Yamaguchi Deathstroke. I'm sure you got to see this thing.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, does this look amazing. But I think, like you, a lot of the joints, I've had a Yamaguchi Deadpool and a few others, and the joints can be really large and a bit odd, but boy, oh boy, this guy can pose like nothing else. Articulated toes, removable knives, swords, and flying kind of scarf, and just beautifully, beautifully done. Got a kind of $80 price point to go with it, but loads of weapons and detail and swap out hands and just tons of stuff in crazy good poses. So joints can be a little bit loose and a little bit flimsy, but still, what an amazing set of photographs. Looking very much like the Deadpool there. Yeah, the joints in these and the shoulders tend to be very visible. Although you don't see them here, they tend to be very visible in the flesh. But wow, what a stunning looking figure. And there he is with the recent Batman release as well. So yes, that was him. That was Yamaguchi Deathstroke. I'd love to buy it, but just $80. Can't do it. Can't do it. Quick, so for Venom, so you haven't seen Venom, and I won't spoil it, but you've heard the reviews.
I've heard the reviews and I've seen the box office.
Good box office.
Huge in Australia. Like, I mean, in Australia, Venom's opening day was bigger than Deadpool 2's.
Ouch. But then again, his second week going to even compete in any way?
I'm sure it won't, but still has done $9 million for an opening weekend in Australia. And that's, you know, Deadpool might have done 11 or 12, but we're talking opening day for Deadpool, I think it was about 2.1 or 2.2 million. And Venom was 2.4 or 2.5 million. It was,
wow.
It was and has been huge for a massively maligned film critically.
It's not terrible. I won't spoil it. CGI does feel a little bit rushed in parts, feels a little bit unfinished. The whole thing feels a little bit rushed. Editing wise, it's chopped up just a little bit. And there's a couple of, it just plot-wise, that's the one that Tom Hardy's pretty good in the whole film, and he really carries it a lot of the time. There is one atrocious wig in that movie. Atrocious. In fact, there's two atrocious wigs in that movie. They're so bad, I noticed them. They were pretty appalling. Jesus, they really take you out of the movie. You're like, what are you wearing in your head?
Is it worthy of Obi-Wan Kenobi's reshot wig in Phantom Menace?
Oh, it's pretty much on that part. It's just like, what? It's just, and the character, one of the characters, his female partner, is incredibly miscast. She doesn't feel comfortable. She doesn't look right. They've got her in a tiny little skimpy skirt. She's not the youngest. It's kind of, that's like teen stuff. And they've kind of dressed her like this, dressed her like 5-10 years younger. It just doesn't look quite right. I don't know. Love to hear your thoughts and comments if you watch Venom. Just a lot of stuff was rushed, and a lot of fight scenes. One of the fight scenes at the end was just, I feel like Star Trek kind of music with the Gorn should come on. It was about, kind of, I don't know, weird, weird movie, something about it. Tom Hardy did say something like 40 minutes of footage that he liked or he felt should have been included was cut.
Probably for the PG rating, I imagine.
It wouldn't surprise me. It was, I expect a Blu-ray of packed stuff. Such a shame. It's such a shame. A lot of people, some mixed stuff, as you said. I think you saw some reviews. I saw a couple of reviews of people saying it was like the best movie ever, and I'm like, no. No, definitely not. But do you plan to go and see it, or do you think?
Oh, look, maybe. I'm going to take some time off. Maybe I'll go see it on one of those days. Maybe I won't. I'm not sure. But anyway, talking about Venom leads me to something which I don't think we did in the last show, and it's not in the notes yet.
Okay.
You get to the Toy Tribe page quickly. There's the Mafex Venom figure, which is outstanding.
Ooh, okay.
Did we talk about it last time? I don't think we did. I just quickly checked up and I posted it.
If I see an image, I'll remember.
So just go to Toy Tribe, and wait a sec, where are we?
This one?
Yep.
Oh, I think we did. I think we did.
Did we?
I think we did.
Go up one. Sorry. There's the individual ones. Yeah, that one you can click through all the different.
I didn't do it. I think we did the other picture, but I don't think we did this one. That's not bad. It's not bad.
It's got the right proportions for his.
It does have the right proportions. You're right. You're absolutely right there. I always felt the Hasbro one was very odd. The head kind of didn't sit right, and it's a kind of weird figure. Kind of, again, for such a great and core figure, they've got the tone right, the kind of black and blue.
Yeah.
And the teeth here on the heads.
Got the eyes right.
Mm.
And I actually thought of a use with the Kraven pack as well, because if you've read the Kraven's Last Hunt, spoiler alert, whatever, but it's not that major. Kraven becomes Spider-Man for a period of time in his black outfit. So the Marvel Legends body of Venom would work perfectly with Kraven's head put on it.
That's a good point. Yeah, it really would. Damn, I shouldn't have sold my Venoms. Damn. Very cool. That's a much more toned down head sculpt than the Hasbro one, which was just awful. I think it's terrible. But
it looks like the head fits the body, unlike
it does.
That.
Great, it really does, and it's the proportional build for it. The other one just doesn't look great. Yeah, that's much nicer. Looks like an orc. It looks like a killer whale. That's nice. That's a good point. Yeah, that's a good point. Let's stick that in the show notes just while I remember. So yes, we were talking about Venom at the movie, so love to hear your thoughts and comments for those of you that and on anything that we're talking about tonight. Please do leave a note underneath and tell us what you think of these figures, these reveals, the stands, the Venom, the Yamaguchi. Let us know what you think. Leave a note for Matt and I, please. We will get back to you. Wolverine in and out of stock. This figure has just, my god, this thing is in and out. And there just doesn't seem to be any stock. I don't think it's gone up for long, but the Marvel Legends Sentinel and Wolverine, which is a beautiful looking set, I think. I just love the packaging on it. A gorgeous big box. It's just beautifully done. And that, again, gorgeous front cover to the box of the old comics. It's worth displaying just for that in its own. It is in and out of stock all the time, consistently in and out of stock. I love that Wolverine. I'd really love to get hold of that. But again, oh, God, it's so cool.
How's it work? I can't remember. Is it? Is that a 3.75-inch Wolverine?
No, it's a 6-inch. 6-inch.
So, geez, how big is that other one?
I think it's 12, 15 inches, something like that. Jeez. He was always really big. 6-inch scale Wolverine. It doesn't say the Sentinel, the size. I can't remember.
We'll go with at least 2.5.
A 21 inches bulk box. I'd suggest that's about 4 inches or 18 inches, something like that.
Yeah, okay.
He's quite tall. He's quite tall, but very comic. Classic colors. They get the colors right this time. They did re-release this in the past, and just looking very much like that Days of Future Past cover. So I'm sure X-Men fans will adore that if they could actually get hold of it. So yeah, I don't know what's going on. I'm sure there'll be some more coming in stock, but anyway, there's a link in the show notes if you really want to hunt it down. This was a cool custom, which I thought I just wanted to very quickly share before we get to all of Matt's juicy stuff. I think this was Mike De La Paz. Yes, this was. I'm sure you probably saw this. Is retooled and repainted, so it's not just a repaint, but it's not a million miles away. Mike De La Paz, someone we've showcased both before, just taking the kind of, I mean, again, kind of seeing the sculpt is there, because certainly the body sculpt is there, and he's just repainted the belt, the lower torso, the blue, and of course, slightly retooled a different head, but my God, that's Chris Evans, that head. That's just, that looks terrible in comparison.
That's Chris O'Donnell on the left.
I know. Tom, what was going on with that one? From some angles, the Marvel Legends one didn't look too bad, but yeah, it really, it's not doing great, that one. Anyway.
Let's also face it, whilst we can, the SH figure arts one was shocking as well.
That's true. That's very true. So, Mike De La Paz, you're the only one who has captured Steve Evans. The farewelling cap, you captured him better than anybody so far.
You just called him Steve Evans, not Steve Rogers.
Steve Evans. Steve Rogers. Steve Rogers. Cap. I'll just call him Cap. This is why we should do the show late at night, because I'm always like, half asleep. Moving on. This is something which I just received. Actually, these guys were very kind enough to send ready sets. I'd heard about this. Didn't think much about it, really, because it never clicked with me, but these are pretty amazing. This was, it's a kind of cardboard. It's like a laminated, high-quality cardboard display. There's two variations. One is it's called an urban playset, and one is a sci-fi playset. And Mrs. Finally died the last night we brought this thing. It was absolutely huge. And we set this up and it was just massive. She was able to stick her head through one of the portals in it. So it is a big, big playset. Absolutely huge. I'll get a proper review done. But just to give an idea of the scale of this thing. And it so suits Spidey figures and characters. Let me just jump in the show notes to, where did I have that link? If I can go there, where are we? Resets.com, here we go. We do it live, people. So yeah, two play sets. Literally, you take this thing out, unfold it, flap something down, and it's done. It's set up. So it's nice and easy if you, you know, you want to set something up for the kids, but then, you know, you kind of, or the big kids, the big adults, and then you want to put away at night, there's a little bit of a gift there. It will play in just a second, and you can see it kind of folding up here. Put the two big flaps up, the one in the middle, and presto, kind of folds in on itself. And it's really thick, durable, kind of plasticky laminated cardboard. But this thing is like all the way around 360. There's stuff on the back, there's stuff on the sides, right in beneath everything. They've added some toys here just to kind of show some details, but it's pretty spectacular. Add Spidey and all the kind of, there you go, there's a couple of shots down here. Wolverine, there's all sorts of kind of things, like there's a drain pipe that opens up and you can go underneath and it's got a whole other kind of area. Great for Batman and definitely for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which, did you order the NECA ones that we were talking about, the games?
Not yet.
No. Oh, I had to do it, man. had to do the other from pop culture. Really, really good. But there's a couple of Spidey shorts as well, and Batman, and very, very impressive. So definitely worth checking these things out. ReadySets.com. And there's a space one in there too. There's where's the different one? Oh, there you go, Space Base. So this could be, where's the details of the set? Hopefully we've got a bigger picture here. Anyway, we'll get a review done of it, but the space one could be, well, Star Wars, kind of Death Star-ish. That's what took me back in thinking of Kenner figures. And it's kind of between, it's almost best suited for 5-inch figures because the height's just that little bit smaller, but it works on pretty much all of them. But yeah, anyway, very worth checking out. Considering for long enough we don't get dioramas and play sets and we wait for years for things like Space Walls, this was pretty nice to see something like that. That was Ready Sets. Let's get on to the good, the juicy part of the show. Instagram.com/ Star Wars The Black Series. And this is all of Matt's curated toy photography, as well as some of the images that we just covered, as well as some other angles. You get another close-up of Luke there, I think.
I just cropped harder on it. Let's get a better look at the heads.
Nice. Like the paint on the hair. Looks really good. They've really added that kind of slick effect. And maybe some weathering. Nice weathering, it has to be said. Very subtle weathering on that one.
Nice. And it's the first, finally the first Hamill face to... We've had good ones, not great ones. It's just the first one. We get the new face paint technology, digital paint job. The sculpt's a good sculpt. It's coming in just an era of everything coming together, and it's a great Mark Hamill head.
I agree. It's a shame the it's not such a big issue because it's going to be off most of the time, but that Stormtrooper helmet is redonkulous when you put it on his head. That looks like the exact same one that came with the figure, which is a bit of a shame, but it'd be great just to do a head swap and just rather than the helmet. You know what I mean? Just have a separate head. But there we go. We're getting a look, so I'm very happy. Archive. So probably a good point to talk about it, but unless you get some...
If you go a little bit further down, I've got the archive shots. There's a bit of a break between between days.
Did you have that one?
Yep, so there's...
the Slade set one?
No, I've got the actual ones on display from Thursday.
Let me just get a thing. Just posted it. There we go. Star Wars Action News had it. No. Go back. Made a lot of good. So there we go. So that was just what I thought we were going to cover. There was a repainted head for Anakin. A repainted head for Yoda, and a re-release of the Biker Scout was another slide that they had. Never gave us any glams for them. Did see the Yoda. I did see a close-up of the Yoda, which looked pretty good. Let me go back to your page now. And again, you covered this, I think, the nice screenshot. Literally. Looking good with Scott Miller. And this was the sci-fi panel again, which is kind of a weird panel to reveal this stuff on, wasn't it? It was kind of bizarre. I was like, why? Sci-fi channel?
Yeah.
I guess.
Had to do something between Thursday and Sunday.
Yeah, I suppose. Do you like that packaging? Very 40th anniversary size. Very nice. Very nice indeed. So you get some other shows. There we go. There's the Biker Scout. So previously done. What is interesting there is, now that could just be they put that in his hand just for whatever.
The wrong size. The IG-88's one?
Well, if you remember way, way back, Star Wars in 3.7 5-inch released to celebrate one of the first Battlefront games, they just basically put a biker scout, put a sniper or a longer rifle in his hand and said it was a Biker Scout sniper or something like that. I can't remember the exact name of it. And it was a big, big seller at the time. And ever since then, they've almost included that character in games that the Biker Scouts were snipers to. And I think that's why they've given them that blaster, which is kind of nice. but I don't know whether that's genuinely going to be in the box.
So the only difference as well on this is the grey pouches.
That's true, which I think is more accurate from memory.
Yeah.
I think you're right, but quite what a still a stunning figure, and it goes back to what you and I have been saying all along, that they, when they made some of these originally, they made them with utter love, and it really shows. Not that they don't make them with love now, but they spent a lot more on the mold and time on them, I think, way back than perhaps some have had through the line. But that's nice. You had another close-up of Dengar there, looking good. That new facial sculpt looking much better indeed. He's weathering. The shot of Lando, which is always nice to see. He's looking great as well.
I think he's my pick of the end of year figures. I think I'm more excited about him than...
Really?
Well, him and Dengar are the two.
Mm.
More so than some of the Solo figures and the layers and stuff. I just think they've done such a great job on it.
I am in love with this guy. He looks fantastic.
Doesn't he look like he's meant to be sitting on a bike?
He does. Well, his little triangular sandwich thing that he rides.
Yeah.
The little speeder. I'm surprised we didn't get one of him, but I thought they'd pack that in and make a...
Maybe they'll reverse it and we're going to get this individual one and then maybe it'll be someone's exclusive.
Different colors or something, or who knows? That's a good point.
A vehicle exclusive.
Again, great looking facial sculpt with Leia and her different outfit and the welding gear from the Falcon scene. Beautiful. Very nice. They don't eat... they always have these banana-like clear stands with hot glue on them. They always hot glue everything. So even they seem to be afraid of pegs, I think, because of the difference in sizes. It is very hard considering there's like five different sizes or four different sizes for pegs and figures, it seems. So, yes. Chopper, looking very good. Very muted kind of orange here, but the light's hitting it nicely. Very, very nice indeed. And this was from the Hasbro Breakfast. And the rest of them we'd seen. There's another close-up of... hello there. That's it. Wow, Ezra's looking very cool. His little waistcoat's tiny. Of course, you meant this is the realistic version. It's not meant to be animation perfect. Not quite sure they've still nailed that Anakin yet, though. Really,
it's prototype head. I think it's a... Personally, I would have put the Sith head on him because the Sith head down on the ground in other pictures looked better than this head. And it's a prototype paint. It's not the actual production figure.
Mm. And is that a change to the soft goods underneath?
No, I think they've just, it's pushed to the side. It's just, once again, bad display practice, a bit like Grievous's cape.
Yeah, that's odd. Yeah, so an archive release for Obi-Wan. Any other shots from the con?
Bit lower down. It's kind of a bit mixed up given how much...
Yeah. Oh, there you go. Get some up here. My Trooper. God, he looks great. Absolutely fantastic. And Han Solo underneath, so that'll be a popular figure. A little bit of an army builder for that one, without a doubt. Corby's Glaive with a proper head on. Now that's looking better.
Yeah.
That glam shot. That is looking good with the facial, the details on him. Pretty nice indeed.
It's looking less out of proportion as well.
It does. A nice cape and stance and the flow on that's really nice. And it's been put in a good position. It looks really good. What else we got? Yoda. Oh, look at the Yoda. What an improvement on that Yoda with the eyes.
Yeah.
Wow. Same figure, just different head and paint. That is such a change. I'm just looking.
But did you say same, different head?
It's the same head.
Yeah, same head. Just, yeah, sorry.
It looks different. But yeah, same head. People really moaned and bumped their gums the fact that it came with a lightsaber. And you didn't have a lightsaber in that sequence. And get really kind of like just over the top nerdy about it. I remember when it came out with a lightsaber. But I don't see it there. Hopefully it will just be repacked in, but yeah, maybe people will be up in arms again. But what a difference that facial sculpt makes.
It's incredible.
More of Grievous and Obi-Wan there. Hello there again.
That was the shot where I just was like, gosh, I got to post everything now. I was about to go to bed on Thursday night. It was 12:30 a.m. when these pictures all hit, and I was just like, oh, I'm in for the long haul.
I know.
That's the cape the wrong way round, where I was just like, what's going on there?
Yeah, it needs to be positioned under his... Looks very different. Looks very muted there compared to the one in the glam shot. And thicker, because it's double lined there. But oh, these things always look kind of different in hand. Sometimes you're just incredibly pleased, and sometimes it's not. But I think that was pretty much all your press.
That's the stuff from
so let's go back down to where we last. I think you probably posted the little thumbnail for the show. We'll do it justice and go back because you had some
grand
shots. There we go. I like that's the Revader on the that's such a good shot. There's something funny about that too, the way he's kind of hovering above it, but it's nice. I like that.
Yeah, yes. I'm pretty sure he does go back to Tatooine in the comics. I'm pretty sure he rides the speeder bike. It's as bizarre as it looks. It feels like it comes out of one of the pages of the comics.
I feel it's like the days of where Hasbro used to, in the kind of heyday when it was all 3.75 inch. That's kind of something we would have got, was basically a repaint of a speeder. And, you know, if there was a whisper of a Vader being on a speeder in some shape, size, or form, Hasbro would have just resprayed, repacked, got it out in the channel. And I kind of miss that in some ways. There was an endless stream of toys, but there you go. Nice shot, BSLR.toys. Got to have our Scarif Trooper. It's a little video. Oh, nice. A little bit of snowy effect. Not getting tired of these troopers, man. They are just getting better.
There's a few of them over the last few weeks for you.
Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Moloch or Moloch, whatever we do. I just finally managed to get one. He looks good. I love the fact his little staff is basically souls. And did you see that? Have you seen that?
Close? Yeah.
That's pretty gruesome. That was Got Moof Milk. Get a look at that as well. Nice hand shot. By Robot Food 567. That's nice. I like the diorama there.
Yeah.
Very cool. And that's beautiful. I like the distortion in the background there.
Yeah, it just looks like it's got that grading of one of those classic 70s Star Wars picks.
Pre-special edition VHS quality. Black Series Bonanza. I like. That's a great show as well. That's a great figure too. The more I see it on a shelf, the more I really like it. It's very cool. I picked up the Solo Blu-ray and was watching through some of the special features, and they did a fantastic job of keeping, was it Lord and Miller?
Yeah.
Completely ignoring them in the entire, whatever they show.
What did they do? They kind of referenced one or two things on the round table about them.
Is that what it was?
I think so. And then there was those, To give them some credit, although there's still rumors that they're possibly suing Lucasfilm. So that's probably why they're keeping a shut shop. But yeah, what's the Kasdan's son's name? Is it Jake Kasdan?
I know who you mean. Yep.
He did his 52 points of information and inside when they released the Blu-ray and or digital release or whatever it was. And within that 52 points of things you didn't know, he gave a few tidbits of what they, 3 or 4 points were like, these are Lord and Miller ideas that we've carried on or what they brought to the table. He gave them some questions and scenes that, like, for example, I can't remember what it was, but they were very much involved with what most people consider to be one of the best scenes of the film, which was the Han and Chewie fight.
Yes.
That was something a lot to do with them. They brought that to the table, but then that was one of Ron Howard's first shooting days, reshooting that scene. But something to do with that scene was their idea.
Shower scene, maybe.
Yeah.
There are still people out there on Twitter. I had some troll the other day. I'm going to go see a movie where a Wookiee and a man get the shirt together. Are you for real? I just, Oh my God, just some very bizarre people out there. Anyway, nice shot of Tarkin and Darth here. Space walls, baby, that's what they are, and they look great. Kind of smoky effect too, I like that, by Haz Ennis. Looking good. What would you need? That's a nice shot with the little scanners. Todd Hoffer. Looking good. What head sculpt is that?
It's a customed one.
Wow, that's pretty impressive. That looks like an old Marvel comic. I remember that pose.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Rebel Fleet Troopers looking good. Yeah, we've got to get Luke X-Wing Pilot is got to be in the archive lane there too. So
he is. Remember, he's in the first wave.
Is he?
With the bounty hunters.
Why have they not shown any packs of them?
Because why? They said on Sci-Fi that they were just focusing on the bounty hunter reveal.
Oh, they did. Of course they should. Yeah, they should.
Luke was announced at Comic-Con in San Diego.
That's right. It's such a good lane, this archive, just being able to get older figures again.
I've seen people, and it's everyone's entitled to their opinions, but still the people begrudging the archive line. I'm just like, eh.
For real?
Yeah.
Why?
It's, you know...
devaluing the line of...
Not devaluing, it's for the collector. These are collectors, so it's suggesting it's just Hasbro cashing back in again, but I'm like, it's...
Don't buy it then.
Killing the secondary market, it's servicing people who do need it. Some people did miss it. I'm just like... Man, I'd like to see every great figure on that archive thing eventually. If it's a great figure, I want to see it on the archive card at some point.
That's just, oh, man. People are just, sometimes when you post stuff or see things online these days, it's just, it's depressing. Anyway, this is the 6-inch, but I have to share this because I find it really funny. And I saw it the other day. I really liked it. What is going on here? Glazy UK post, the Palatoy Death Star.
My cousin found that and sent it to me. He's like, you gotta put this on your Star Wars page. Because it just speaks to us. So we must have spent, I don't know how many hours putting Chewie and Han and Luke down that chute.
In the trash compactor, yeah.
Kind of thing. And it was a hilarious picture. I'm like, you know what? Yeah, it's not 6-inch, but it's hilarious. And that's toy photography circa 1981.
Oh, man, that's funny. That is funny. We were so happy with those figures at that point. Now everybody seems unhappy with everything. No, don't give me that. Oh, man. Anyway, moving on. What else do we have? Wow. Now that is good weathering.
Yeah.
Heavy on the belt, but that is good weathering. Wow. Very talented indeed. Trip Life by Rogue Studios. Looking good. Nice shot of head. A really cool angle there on the head. That's really, really nice. General Syndulla, Force of Light. Wow. Some space walls, again, in the back. And a wee bit of Sabine cheekily hiding behind one.
Yeah.
That is a gorgeous shot. They really just angled that so nicely. Damn. Very impressed. One really depressed looking biker scout. Wow, worn out trooper. Very bleak. Nice. Again, with that rifle, I should say. He's got the kind of full sniper rifle thing going on. Very popular. The old original Obi-Wan with Jango.
I kind of like to think that this pick is like, you know, Obi-Wan dreaming in Tatooine. It's a dream. He's on Tatooine and Jango still turning up.
Still turning up in his dreams. That's a good point. Nicely steep, though.
Cool shot, yeah.
It was nice. And even the kind of slight cover on that, maybe not the best Obi-Wan facial sculpt, it still looks pretty good. Very well done, the Chip Monsters. More Tarkin.
There's been a lot of Tarkin at late, and they're all good. I'm conscious of how many more I could put on the page.
Never apologize for finding some great toy photography. Bud Futu, is this he's doing his Jabba throwing here?
There's his Jabba throwing some shots, so you can scroll on that one.
Oh my God, look at that. Look at that detail, this is so accurate. I think I saw this actually, yes. Wow. Yes, I did. I saw this the paint. Very, very cool indeed. Just that little detail is just so bloody accurate in the weathering and the kind of cracks and grooves. And it has to be said, the little gargoyles as well.
Yeah, and they were from somebody else, the
Yep.
gargoyles, I think, Figureworks or something.
No, pressed. Pew pew! Like that, non-1072. Looking good. Very moody and broody, and lots of dead triples around there. Nice. Admiral Piette, he's such a good figure.
Yeah.
Nice and smoky in the background. That's Root Leaf Stew Squad. What a great name. That's fantastic. Awesome lighting indeed. I agree. Wow. Now, what is this? Some cardboard diorama, a plastic diorama?
I think it's a
Wow.
custom diorama or it's a 3D printed one, but
Wow, Star Wars Rick. I expected Leia down there rather than Darth, but still looks
oh,
good.
look, there's other ones with Leia in there and stuff, but this is just kind of mixing A New Hope with the Rogue One.
That's true, true. These pipes and all sorts of detail. Very cool. More of the troopers, not troopers, I should say, lieutenants and moths. That's a great scene. So you did see the solo Blu-ray stuff or deleted scenes or
Yes.
that, so the there's the one scene where the he faces he's actually quite a famous British actor. He was in a show called This Life, and he plays a not a moth, but Han calls him a moth in the Imperial kind of scene where he's been flying a TIE fighter and he crashes it.
Kind
That
of
was
gets
a
court-martialed, didn't he?
court-martial, exactly. What a wonderful scene that was. Oh, we'll make you fly, all right. And then the cut scene was he flies through the
Submission.
absolutely wonderful, made much more sense. I really enjoyed that scene. Such a shame they cut it out. Such a shame. I would have kept
Look,
that in a
I think that scene is like the Kylo Ren walking into the Millennium Falcon in The Force Awakens.
great scene, but they cut it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of all the
Yeah.
deleted scenes, you go, I can understand that one, I can understand that one. But I'm always like, I would have liked to seen Kylo in the Millennium Falcon. And I think it works, but they've got their pacing issues and decisions and whereas I think this is exactly the same scenario. The scene works. It just makes it that little bit longer again, or whatever it is. They want to jump straight to that moment.
Yep,
So.
I agree. What else did we have on your page there? Gammos. What do you call a gaggle? A gaggle of gamma rays? I don't know what you call that. I think there's been some extra added drill going on there. It's very dark,
Possibly,
but
yeah.
some extra goo. There we go. And zoom up a little bit.
Yeah, definitely.
Some dribble. I like it though. Despite the fact it's all the same figures, they look so different, each one of them. There's just something about them. This guy behind here looks fantastic. There's something about them. So
They certainly don't look like three Death Star troopers.
no, they do not. There's something pretty. Yeah, I don't know what it is. Bud Foote, again, great picture. Not toy photography. Yes, Gary Kurtz, sadly. A lot of animal. Have you read the Making of Star Wars, Making of Empire Strikes Back books? I think we've talked about them.
Not really. I've looked at the pictures, never really read them.
It's actually fascinating reading how really Gary Kurtz and George Lucas and others, Irvin Kershner, really did not get along well in the movie. It's heavily read between the lines stuff, but there was a fair bit of trouble on that set, not only from Carrie Fisher and Harrison Ford because of the relationship, but Mark Hamill's and oh, there was a few tense moments. But yeah, Gary Kurtz was definitely there was a few tense moments. That's what I remember of him from reading that book, anyway. But God, what a pivotal scene! Yet again, a scene that could have been cut, and we would never have we'd never have known the bounty hunters. But yeah, sad to see him go. Piet and Veers getting a bit of a lecture from South P24. Both looking very good again, facial sculpt wise. A classic Vader looking good from Visual Force. Once we go, that's nice. That is really nice. All the little flecks of sand there. One, two, three, four, five Tusken Raiders around the camp. All singing Kumbaya. Very cool. From Tusken Milk Bar. I'm guessing he likes Tuskens. this is nice, a kind of storm in a base or something.
Yeah. It's just a great pose for Darth.
Mm. A great pose for the Imperial Trooper with the Praetorian blade, which is actually quite a nice touch there, actually. And this guy's got like a blaster in his hand too. Very interesting. I like that. It's very difficult with these troopers to kind of get a good pose with all the material. Very nice. That's Papa Palpatine photography. Go for Papa Palpatine. Lovely. Wow. Trooper Eddie, who we often cover on this. Stunner. What a great shot. A lot of dead troopers. And another close-up. Still, everybody's got the brown nose gamma. I'm waiting for somebody to find a kind of version where it's green. More size of the figures, looking good. More troopers, again, looking awesome. Love this guy in the mid-fall.
Yeah.
That's quite hard to stage, isn't it, if you think about it? It's really pretty hard.
Stu is a master of posing troopers.
I'm not once it's really two again, yeah. And that looks like a range trooper blaster there. Swap 10, it looks good. Ton, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's a lot of troopers. Nice. Wow. What is different there? Something looks different.
I think it's just the red background.
Wow. That's a black
scene. Like one of those movies. Yeah. Gee. Look how thick the antenna is.
Yeah, you're right. Gee, something about it looks very different. Yeah, I think you're right about the red background. Wow. Looks great.
Really brings out his eyes.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That is stunning. Very nice. Quetam, I think, is the
person. That's for the Fawoosh. That's Matt does the photography for the Fawoosh's Black Series stuff.
Beautiful. Very, very nice. Yeah, I guess we can do all of those figures now. That is very, very cool indeed. Just the lighting there, just what a difference that makes. Gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. And then more. We're doing a little photo story here of the Empire Strikes Back.
Yeah.
It's nice, my friend. Mm. God, another one. This is great. I like your little, this was you and your themes.
Yeah.
Of course it is. Nicely done there to hide the non-Jeremy Bullock face. But that was a great scene. I was thinking the other day how easy it would have been to release Leia with a Jeremy Bullock lieutenant clone head.
Yeah.
A couple of troopers, make a four pack. Hasbro don't really like doing four packs that often. You could, I guess, like the Entertainment Earth, Meyer / lots of other places pack, but you know, the four troopers, they could have done something. A little fountain piece or something like that. Repack a Lando instead. Nice. Deserty scene there going on with the K2SO carrying the backpack. Heavily weathered troops. Chip monsters. Nice. You're loving your Vader. You love that figure, don't you?
I think it's the best Vader, full stop.
I know. It is pretty good. Nice, gorgeous background on that. Big TVB toys. And what else we got? We should be into the panel. Oh, nice. Okay. God, that looks good.
Yeah.
Movie shot. Just the position of the head just sometimes makes such a difference.
Even 3PO looks great.
He does. And there's the old cardboard piece that I should have kept. But totally going to forget that. Never forget that. Nice little bit of trickery with the lightsaber with Jaina. More space walls on the roof too.
Kind of a reimagined Vader Obi fight with a bit of a levitating Vader going on.
Mm-hmm, definitely. That's right from that kind of stunt scene guy that did that shot. Oh, my. Sexy Rexy in a 501st and a very cool pose by Toy Spectre. That is very nice indeed. Beautiful lighting again as well on the red glow. Wow, that's gorgeous. Gorgeous. Yep, she is a stunner. Very, very cool indeed. And the facial paint on both of hers was, they were immaculate, absolutely immaculate. I worried that one of them, the lips, was maybe going to be off or something, but they're both spot on.
Which was the whole point of it. Like, I mean, I think somebody had complained about one of the figures. I'm not sure, maybe a couple of veers. or something, but the whole point of the digital painting was about the fact that, like you and I getting these two figures together, that the digital paint means that 99.9% of them are all exactly the same.
That's very true. Yeah, there's less potential issues. More Leah. Yeah, Leah's because she's hitting targets in the US. She's pretty much been heavy on the toy photography. Even though I've seen that everywhere.
Seeing some people who have cut the head from this figure and fixed up and made a custom Slave Leia. Use this face onto Slave Leia's hair and
really?
Head, wow. Yeah. I'll see if I can find that for next show.
Wow, that'd be interesting. I'm sure Slave Leia will, well, actually probably won't get an arcade release after that grumpy, stupid dad complained about it, but never mind. What a difference these facial sculpts look, that just that kind of known photo scan Death Star Trooper. Nice kind of contrast and tone on it. There's something that they've done to the kind of quality of it, which is
that Piet head looks even more like whoever the actor is.
Yes, that's what I mean. Yeah, I think by having it less sharp and less yeah. kind of detailed and a little bit darker in contrast, it really just adds a more of a realism to it. It's a shame the Death Star Trooper's head's just not quite working. Duke 3001, a very cool shot with Admiral Thrawn. Oh, that's nice too. What a cool shot and angle. And the smoothing kind of out of the picture. Kylo Maxi, looking good for Rebel Fleet Trooper. More of your Darth porn.
Yep. There's plenty of it.
Jason B. Michael. Go there. Is that the original head sculpt? It kind of isn't. It's kind of grayer, I think. Don't know.
Could just be the toning of the picture as well.
Yeah, that's true. The purple eyes. Yeah, this the kind of shape of the hood is, that's for sure. Still looks good. That's definitely one that could be coming back in the archive with a little bit of electric blast fingers. That would be rather awesome, but I doubt they'd add that in. Jubak, any pile, absolute pile of troopers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 4, 8. That is, it's kind of reminiscent of some of those old black and white pictures of all the sand troopers yeah. with their helmets off in terms of the quantity of sand troopers in one shot. God, that's nice. That is really nice. Captured beautifully, just to the right angle. Shooting the galaxy, fine job, and that looks like a cloth cape there.
Yeah.
Just to tweak it. The gang's all here. Like the 3PO, pretty nice. That was such a great scene, chasing the Falcon. Thupoib. And I'm regretting that cardboard. Heavily. Fred's Figs underscore the DLC looks grand. Nice angle, his hand cocks his leg there. Dirty Troopers. Very dirty Troopers, actually. This is why we need more archive figures.
Absolutely. It's an army building now.
Hmm. Lovely angle again, 3PO, and the lighting. Just, I mean, that could be someone's blinds in the window.
They're these things.
That's so cool. It's just, but it looks like the light coming into Bespin.
It looks like a pre-special edition Bespin.
Mm. There you go, peeps. Get creative. Kicks it around. Nice. Toy porn. I love this part of the show. It's so much more entertaining. Why is that not going forward? We reached the end. Leia,
There's that land speeder shot is stunning.
That's nice. Oh wow.
That's a table. That's wood.
What isn't that amazing that makes that look like the motion?
Yeah.
Definitely some extra weathering going on, I think, on that speeder though.
Is it not the special? Is it not the exclusive?
It may well be. True. Looks very well weathered. I don't recall that one being. I had both, but I don't recall it being that much better. I like this with Luke with his hand over the...
Yeah.
Just chilling, going to Toshi Station, as you put there, at Black Series. I like it. Nice floor. I like that with the effects.
There's been some great floors. People have had some great custom carbon freeze floors of late.
Mm. Nice. See that. It looks like a custom solo with the, well, they've added little effects there for the lights. And perfect hibernation. More Piets, more of your Vader porn. I like the display in the background. That is very, man, nice.
GTP toys need to add some red walls.
We need to
be able to make that control room and or these scenes.
Yep, instant purchase for me. Instant purchase. Lock the door. Hope they don't want to blasters. Dirty troopers, filthy troopers, plenty of them, more of our Darth and Pops. That looks more like the Pops of old.
Yeah.
We're used to Jedi fight. Chilling K2SO. Life of Gyar. Looks good. Nice. Rebel love. Very cool. From Fred's Figs _ the DLC. Rex and Vader. Looking good. Yankeet. Nice. That's cool too. Nice angles here too. Very realistic Dirt troops. That's right. Bad boys, bad boys. You think what I think in some of these photographs. I don't look at your titles until I've seen it, but oh my god, he's thinking like me. The Gen Line Way is very cool. That is very nice. And that's just the off the shelf Obi.
Yeah.
That is nice.
Is that Jesse's? I can't remember. I can't see.
It is. Jesse. Of course, with Jesse. Very cool.
Some Adelaide rocks there.
Absolutely. Way to go, Jesse. Up amongst the finest toy photographers. I like it. Chewbacuki is looking very good. They're very moody sunset. More of Leia and Lando. Lando looks great with these cape off. It's very nice. Nice Rogue One shot. That's a very cool looking shot there. Your Vader porn. Anakin Starker. More hand porn. That's nice. Nice little displays and walls too. Rebel Alliance for Brett. Oh, hello. Nice custom. That's very cool. So they've used the same hair there, like, or the same head.
Yeah.
Wow. And they've made the figure. Wow.
They've just pressed her, really.
Jesus, yeah. Damn. Okay, that looks great. Oh, and on the car too, though. Way to go. 40,000.
There's a hint, Mr. Stevie.
There's a hint, but yeah, definitely could do with that. Nice. Such a good figure. Such a good figure. Mr. Veers from Root Leaf Stew Squad. And more your Bespin. Blaine are rare things. We've covered him before. Or her. Random.
Him.
Him. More Tuscan Milk, we've covered them too, but yeah, inspecting the troops. I like it. I think it's nice getting the variety in the troopers, not the troopers, the officers, I should say. Great figure. I really do like Enfys Nest. I think it's a very cool figure as well, and a very good photographer there too. 1 and 3, 1, 4. Vader porn is the theme. Jawa porn is the theme. Nice and smoky there. The Tiny Wars.
Yeah.
I like it. What a great pose. Again, you should have one earlier on that just had that kind of pose, but just that kind of way he's angled. What a difference.
It is funny watching Solo again, just how good he is.
No. We'll skip that in the interest of time, but yes, Mandalorian, Jon Favreau TV series. Very excited.
I'm just going to quickly say about that, the most exciting thing about it is Taika's directing.
That's right, I know.
He's got the last episode of the season, I think.
Wow. Very impressive. What's going on here? This is
that's a poster art for the Clone Wars that Zay has made out of figures.
Wow.
And some graphic, obviously some graphic design, but that's the Gree Toys R Us figure, that's the Cody, and they're all Black Series figures.
Damn. That's slightly bloody impressive. Well, good work indeed, Zay. New York Comic Con, which we've kind of covered tonight. Wow, he looks quite different, that Gamel. Just the contrast again. Star Wars-aholic. Snow Mall. Or is that Water Mall?
Snow.
It's snow. Snowy Mall. Christmas Mall. that's a great facial sculpt. The more I see it, it's definitely a really good one. and worked out very, very well. I just bought a bunch of them from Dorkside because I just thought, yeah, I just can't have one on my shelf anymore.
I got a second one this week as well, actually.
Grievous, and we again covered a lot of this stuff, yeah, so I think we'll skip that. Did we miss any up the top?
Yeah, there's a couple in between now, which is, yeah, there was the Friday.
Dare I say, smoking Palpatine. He looks stunning there. Yeah, call it any other ones.
Fewer the Boba Fett's just in celebration of the Mandalorian announcement.
Nice, nice. That's gorgeous. That looks, wow. A lovely sunset with that picture. Sorry. Tucked into the sunset.
And I love that Boba Fett shot.
This one?
Yep.
Wow.
It's like he's diving down into the underworld of Coruscant.
And then your Comic-Con. This was a nice shot. I like the angle of these two. Staring ahead of the troopers in the background.
Talking to Boba.
Hmm. I like this. He's just kind of like, what are you looking at?
I'm Zuckers. No, I'm Fallon.
Definitely, I like that. Anything about it, it's just awesome. Nice shot too. The TV. Yeah. I like it. Talking away. Very cool indeed. Oh, wow. That looks almost vintage.
Yeah.
Kiwi bookshelf. What is going on there?
Just some cape envy.
Oh, I see again. I understand. I was like, what is he doing to that cape? Oh, jeez. One knee. Nice. Cool Biker Scout by Tiki Berger. And that's a great looking one as well. That could be Mimban, I think.
Yeah, looks great.
Overpat as usual. Very, very, very cool photo. And just, of course, Scarif Porn just for me. They look so good. Never. Oh my God, you mentioned me. Oh my God. What am I like? You know, I'm a complete Scarif slut. Love it. That's a great shot. That's really nice. I like it. She has pick 66. I thought that was through his eyeball there.
No. It's, as the original post said, and I sometimes I just want to take the joke from the other one straight and put it into mine, but it's kind of like, I think his original post was something about, and this little piggy went wee, wee, wee.
Nice.
All
nice.
The way home.
Okay. I see. All right. A wee break. More Baker Scout goodies, Sandra Brigitte's, and then I think we're into glammy shots.
Yes.
Anything on your toy trip you want to...
Look, just quickly, there's the head, which feels like Eddie Brock. It's 10 to 15% too big for the body.
Correct.
But I like it. I'm just like, how do you get your head wrong?
That's a reused Peter Parker, though. That was used on the Cosmic Spider-Man with the beard.
Right.
Something else. That was used somewhere else. So yeah, it doesn't work, does it?
It's too big.
There's another shot of that Black Cat. And I think I saw a couple of silver seals as well in the background. He's 6 inch?
6, 7, I don't know. But they call them awesome. 6. I love them.
They look really good. There was a great little Netflix show, which not the Toys That Made Us, but it was made by the Toys That Made Us crew.
It's incredible. They talk about the movie and all that stuff.
Yeah. I didn't realize it was a great line of Masters Universe in the early 2000s, and they looked fantastic.
Spectacular. Like, I mean, these ones, the minute they were the Maddie Collector, they went out as the Maddie Collector ones, and you could pre-order them, and once they were pre-ordered, that was it. And they instantly went from, and I think you had to buy all of them, or I can't remember, all four of them to get them, but anyway, they were $35 figures that went up to $100 straight away. The minute they were finished, they went straight up to $100. And what they're doing now is re-releasing those figures with two new heads onto the vintage card, because they came in their Maddie Collector square box with the Grayskull packaging and all that stuff. So everyone's going to get another shot at these two guys, and they're stunning.
They are, actually. Very impressed. Super 7. Yeah, I like that. Vintage Collection, that's 3.75. That's a skinny Joker.
So I will go back up just to the Long Halloween photo, the one next to Luke. Go down the Joker underneath Han. These were the figures. Like, I mean, this is what the 6-inch stuff I was collecting before I took my break, before Black Series brought me back. Mm. The DC Direct stuff. They were so comic accurate and so brilliant and respectful to the artist and their work. DC Direct used to do such a great job of that stuff. Not as much articulation as, say, the Marvel Legends, but
sure.
Man, they would do these Tim Sale stuff. Was it Tim Sale? Yeah, it was Tim Sale. And then they'd do the Jim Lee stuff, and then they'd do the things from Darwin Cook, and they all looked like they came straight off the page.
Wow. Nice. I do like the Two-Face detail. It's just shockingly good. That is gruesome. Gruesome. This, I don't know, did we miss that off the shows? I can't remember, but
yeah, we missed it. I think
we missed it anyway. Nothing too exciting. The GameStop US / EB Games Australia / I don't know whether it's coming to EB Games in Canada, but I would presume so. Gamerverse Marvel PS4 Spider-Man figure, in a package basically. So, yeah. Nothing we hadn't really seen before. So, yes, there you go. But to be completists, we covered it. I love this. Was this a 6-inch or 3.7?
It was a mixture of SH Figure Arts and Black Series, so I put it onto Toy Tribe.
Loved it. That is, if I'm correct, I was just about to say that. Yes, it is absolutely kind of identical to a Marvel cover, but yes, of course, that's the inspiration for it. Love that cover. In fact, I think I've still got it, if it's one of the lower numbers. I love it. That's very, very cool indeed. Talented Tones 1138. Thing.
Custom thing head.
I know, I like that with the cigar. That is very cool indeed. I've seen a few people do that, give him a cigar. One thing I noticed, he doesn't have a number 4 in his belt, which is very bizarre. But cool nonetheless. But they're looking great, the whole squad, now they're all together. And they're very, very cool indeed. Nice. Lots and lots of things hitting stores. Yeah, if you've got a Walgreens near you, you are getting drowned by things. And if you're not, that's because they've been scalped and shoved up in eBay for double the price. That was the cable swap ahead by Old Boy CTTS.
Yeah.
Which was pretty nice. Great pack. I love that yellow jacket.
You think you pick that up?
No.
Not yet. Oh, I saw it on Amazon at $64.
Australian, yeah, it's still pretty cheap for us. Even for US prices, that's cheap, actually.
Yeah, so the thing about these figures is Yellow Jacket and Ant-Man so lends itself to any scale of toy photography.
That's true. That's absolutely true. Very, very good point. You could use any kind of prop around there to kind of manipulate it.
Your whole house is a diorama.
Yeah. I have this little link. That is awesome. I just bought it recently.
Yeah, okay. It's awesome.
A link to the past. Nice. Wow, that's the old... I used to have that, the Hot Toys.
This was for Batman Day. I did, I think, about 9 different Batman posts. 12-inch, 6-inch.
Just didn't move, sadly.
like the movie character.
Yeah, just exactly. It just didn't move. Yeah, for Batman Day. And that was the Mezco. Was it Mezco?
Yeah.
You were talking about before.
I think we've done these ones now.
Boy, CTTS. Yeah. I think we covered some of them.
Yeah, I think we did these ones last week, the last show.
Anything else we missed you want to talk about, cover, plug?
No, I don't think so. What have I been buying? I bought 4 Tusken Raiders.
Okay.
I think they're $20 each or 25 or something, red packs.
Oh, yeah. Was it online or was it in a store?
Online. I think it was actually a little toy company. We're doing a Black Series sale, a spot sale. And I was like, I think they're $20 each. I was like, oh, I'm going to get five. It's like, oh, you can only order four. I went, okay.
Wow.
They shipped the next day. So it was.
Is that 40th card?
No. Redbox.
The Redbox.
Yeah. Nice. Ironically, I have about four on 40th card and I didn't have any Redbox. Because they never hit really here on the shelf.
No, they didn't, did they? They were actually quite hard to find in the Redbox, I think.
Yeah.
God, that distro, those figures, and the 40th, oh, it was just hell. Anyway.
I think last time we did the show, I already had the Hulkbuster and Hulk.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yeah, maybe by the time we do the next show, I'll deal what else I've got.
Okay. Sounds good. I think we have a lot of Black Series, to be honest. 6-inch figures, The Thing, managed to get. Moloch, if that's how you pronounce him, her, whatever. Leia Bespin, Escape. And I think that's about all I can recall off the top of my head. I'm sure there's been others, because it's just an endless stream of things and figures. But I think that's it from Matt and I. Thank you for watching this episode 30 of the New York Comic Con coverage and our thoughts and input. Long show, but fun. We'll be back, I guess, with another edition as soon as we can, as soon as the news is out there. So.
That's what we should say, actually. October 26th,
you're away.
November 4th. In between that, there's one that starts on two that start on October 26th. I think it's London MCM and the Paris Con. And then there's another on the 31st of October that goes to the 4th of November. And that's where we're getting the final reveals of the year, which they've already said is prequel figures.
Yep, which we kind of know anyway.
So that's all happening in 3 weeks' time.
I forgot about that. Cool. Good call. There you go. Lots of cool figures still to come. But let us know what you thought of tonight's show. If you want a comment, question, please leave a comment underneath the video on YouTube. We'd love to hear from you. Thanks for watching. And we will see you for another episode coming up soon. Bye.
Bye.